Good evening, and welcome to Shepherd Shofar International Harvest Ministry, sponsored by Shepherd Fold Ministry. Amen. And if you have your Bibles tonight, you're gonna need some participation. We're coming from Proverbs chapter 16. Now, as we know in the body, that there is 31 proverbs for every day. So, proverbs is an everyday. I found out that reading proverbs, something that I done read that day in the proverbs, it happens in my life, or I see it come to pass in somebody else's life. I'm like, wow. So I've always, I know over the last 20 years, I've always read Proverbs every day. So today is March the 16th. So we be coming from Proverbs chapter 16. I'm going to read. Y'all going to read. We going to fellowship. Old Bible study. Lawrence, you got your sword with you? All right, get your mic so you can be, we can hear you from back there, sir. Mr. Perry, Junior, old man. Yes. Yeah, the Similac I see is just dried up. You see it right there. Yeah. Amen. Love my brother, man. Thank God for bringing him in my life, man. Yeah. All right. Let's start with Proverbs chapter 16. We'll start at verse 1. Well, I got the Amplified and I got the King James here. It says, the plans and reflections of the heart belong to man, but the wise answer of the tongue is from the Lord. That's from the Amplified. And it says, verse 2, all the ways of a man are clean and innocent in his own eyes, and he may see nothing wrong with his actions. But the Lord weighs and examines the motives and intents of the heart and knows the truth. You know, a lot of people like to say, God know my heart. He truly does. He truly knows your heart. And so he know that what's in it. So you cannot fool the Lord at all. People just don't know that. When they say that, I just be laughing. I say, yeah, he do know your heart. And so you know what you think, and you know what you then did, and he already knows. So, you know, you need to be going repenting. For real, since he know your heart. We coming from Proverbs chapter 16. We just got through reading the second verse. We going to get participation tonight. We reading. So now I'm going to read. Y'all going to read. We going to have fun. Because I see a lot of angels over here filling these chairs. Yes. We just got through reading verse 2. Who want to read the verse 3? Or you can either one of King James. Amen. Commit your works to the Lord. Everything we do, we're supposed to do it as we're doing it unto the Lord. And that's what on my job, and I've always, since I've been in the Lord, I've always, everything I do at my job, I'm doing it, I'm doing it unto the Lord and not to man. And God has truly blessed me doing that, showing me favor. Wherever I was at, even when I was back there, he showed me favor. He's showing me favor now. So you commit your works to the Lord, submit to him, he's going to bless you. All your plans will succeed if you obey what he is telling us to do. He's going to succeed. It ain't going to fail. Verse 4, the Lord has made everything for his own purpose, even the wicked according to their role for the day of evil. Like God had told Pharaoh that he raised him up for a day, for such a time as this, so God's glory can be shown back then, when back there in Egypt, when God brought all them plagues against them gods. Yeah, he brought Pharaoh up just for this, so his glory can be shown, so he can be at the glory. And so the wicked, they have their time. They are created for a reason, you know, and we're created for a reason. We're coming from Proverbs chapter 16, starting at verse 4, brother. Welcome. We'll be participating. We'll be asking you to read, too. Amen. Anybody want to elaborate on that verse right there? 4? Yes.
And things that are going on, but we know that Lord is in control. He knows what's going on. And when he wants it to end, that's when it'll end.
Like it says in Proverbs 21:1, it says he has a king heart in his hands like a water course. He turns which way he wants. God letting you know, I'm in control. I'll place you there. And nothing surprised him. He's all knowing. Amen. Verse 5. Who mocked the poor reproaches his maker, and he that is glad at calamity shall not be unpunished. And in Amplified said, everyone who is proud and arrogant in heart is disgusting and exceedingly offensive to the Lord. Proud heart. Yes. Yeah. Pride comes before the fall. A person that used to come and teach on prosperity, not on covenant, used to always talk about pride comes before the fall. And you'll see over the years, many rulers, many actors, sports stars, you know, whatever they may be, what field they may be in, they let pride get in the way, and then you'll see them fall. Because pride, that's one of the reasons why the enemy got kicked out of heaven. He let pride, his pride, because God created him, he was beautiful. And he let that, he started looking at himself in the mirror, look at me. And before, if we don't be careful, you get a promotion. You know, you can look at, oh, look at me. I did this and I did that. No. God allows us to be able to have things, be able to get promotions, be able to, raise up in the morning. He is in control of everything. So don't be careful. Don't let pride slip in. You give glory and honor to where glory and honor is due. Because we don't wake ourselves up. We don't put breath in our body at all. You know. Amen. That's right. Yeah. You can look at Putin. When you see him on TV, you see it all over. You see him, pride all over him. Yeah, you can see it all over him. It goes back up to verse 4. The Lord has made everything for his own purpose, even the wicked according to their role for the day of evil. Yeah, you're right. It's part of the plan. It says, verse 6, by mercy and loving kindness and truth, not superficial ritual, wickedness is cleansed from the heart. And by the fear of the Lord, one avoids evil. Amen. Why do you want to read verse 7?
When the Lord takes pleasure in anyone's way, he causes their enemies to make peace with him.
Man, I know that person. I love that. I love that scripture there. Go ahead, Brother Lawrence.
That's a good one, because basically that's letting you know that even people who meant to do you harm, when you are walking in the ways of the Lord, they can't touch you. They want to do something to you, but he won't allow them to have any power or authority over anything that you are doing or that you're placing your hands to. And so we have to be mindful that just because you walking in his ways don't mean people attached to you are walking in his ways.
Mm-hmm.
And so then that's when he starts to attack them. And you have to recognize that it's not them. It's a spirit that's attached themselves to them,
mm-hmm,
because I can't get you.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to get your children. I'm going to get your spouse. I'm going to get someone on your job.
Mm-hmm.
I'm some kind of way I have to try to get you to get out of alignment with what God's will is for you.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to attack people that are close to you. And if you don't recognize that ain't you, that's you don't even act like that. So I'm praying against this spirit that's attaching itself to you to try to get to me, because it know it can't attack me head on. So mm-hmm, I'm going come in an invert way and try to seep into your house. So we just had that right there lets me know, like, okay,
I'm peaceful, but my neighbor or my kid or anybody that's close to me might be going through some hell because of me.
Amen. Yeah. And I know that as scripture be so true in my life, many people, you know, want to get me. And I used to be in fights all the time. But when I started living for the Lord, their heart, God changed their hearts, you know, and ones that want to fight, then now they want to break bread, you know. So I know when your ways pleases him, he make even your enemies be at peace with you. Amen. It takes away, you know, the worry and the always looking behind you, and you know, because God got you covered. He has you covered. And what a bit more peaceful sleep a person gets. For real. Amen. Verse 8 says, A gift is as a precious stone in the eyes of him that have it. Whatsoever it turneth, it prospers. Oh, I'm reading the wrong one. I read chapter 17, verse 8. Better is a little with righteousness than great ravines without right. Revenues without right. And it says in Amplified, better is a little with righteousness than great income gained with injustice. Yeah. Yeah. Verse 9. Want to read that? Go ahead, sis.
In their hearts, humans plan their course, but the Lord establishes their steps.
That's right. Our steps are ordered by the Lord. So we don't. That's why we have to listen. We have to listen to the Holy Spirit, because we don't know what God has for us that day. We don't know what God is leading us. We don't know who God bringing across our path. So we have to, you know, listen to the Holy Spirit and let him guide us. That's what he's here to do, leading God us in all truth. Verse 9 says, Amplified, a divine decision given by God is on the lips of the king as his representative. His mouth should not be unfaithful or unjust in judgment. God placed us, that's why I'm saying, those that God has placed in a position that has authority over us, those judges, those in a political office, presidents, and don't they know they have a great responsibility? And if they're not seeking the Lord, man, they in trouble. They in trouble because God has placed them with great responsibilities. You know, they like kings, president, you know. And then judges, you are supposed to uphold the law that God has set forth, and you don't, and he placed you in that position, you're in trouble. You in serious trouble. You know, it's just like a evangelist or a apostle or pastor, all those that teachers that God has placed with great authority and place them, they don't do what they in great, in trouble. In trouble. Verse 11 says, a just weight and balance are the Lord's. All the weights of the bag are his work. So as we know, everything is a balance. You got to be balanced in everything you do, you know. What's going on there, sir? You want to read verse 12?